people of Reddit, what was your frick? I need to figure out my life moment. Sitting in my apartment babysitting and my 4-year-old niece told me she wanted to grow up to be just like me. I thought about that exact scenario, unemployed again, uneducated still. I look around the apartment, empty cupboards, empty booze bottles. Outside there are 2 and 2 halves of different cars, none running. Always this project or that project. I thought to myself, frick that, she needs a better role model. Still working on it, huge improvements though. Yeah, not much is scarier than thinking some kid is growing up to be like you. Sitting in the side of the road after I'd just crashed my car. I hadn't paid my insurance, so knew I was in deep crap. As I sat there waiting for my mum to come rescue me, I realized I hated my life. I was unemployed, overweight, miserable and pathetic. I knew it was time to stop making excuses and sort my crap out. I had just ended a pretty rough patrol in Basra, Iraq with the Brits. We had taken a break and were all sitting up against a wall in an alley out of the sun. It was probably 125 outside and I remember looking at the sweat stains on my boots and thinking, man, I don't want to be doing this in 10 years. 4 years later, I had separated from the military and was in college. Got my BA, went back and got my MBA. 10 years later I'm sitting at a desk in a very comfortable corner office making 3 times what I was 10 years ago and staring at my keyboard thinking, frick, I need to figure out my life. Surprise ending. Jobs that don't involve exercise are more depressing than jobs that do, I've noticed. I had just started seriously dating the woman who would become my wife. She was still in school and I drove a flatbed wrecker to make a living. She moved in and I paid to help her finish school. She got a pretty bad flu and was sick as heck. I stayed up with her one night, making sure she was breathing because she was so congested. I realized we were living paycheck to paycheck and had no medical insurance. So if this was something really bad, we'd be screwed. I put my degree to work a few months later and haven't looked back. This made me happy. Hope your marriage goes well, bro. When my friend with whom I used to do coke was shot in the back by a coke dealer and paralyzed for the rest of his life, that was kind of an aha moment for me. The capital C in coke makes me picture him selling red and white branded soda pop. When I was 22, unemployed and my girlfriend said she was pregnant, I've worked my butt off climbing the income ladder since. I've also wanted to go back to school and make an actual career, but financially and time-wise it's a bit difficult. I'll find a way. Finding out my GF was pregnant during my senior year of HS. Next one was 9 years later catching my wife. Same lady from HS. I was 19, she was 26 when we got married, having an affair and realizing I was fat, 275, 6 feet 0, and about to be dating again. My life had taken a detour for a few years. After an acid trip I realized I had to do something, if I wanted to become somehow human again. Walking around tripping in my apartment and all the mess that had been piled up and I got clarity of my situation. The next day I started to clean up all the stuff which had the past and my shame melted into it. You were not the same after that. When my fiancé left me because she fell in love with law school, I was $10,000 in debt, overweight, and not following my dreams, all at the tender age of 20. When I was spending so much time on the computer that I was not getting any exercise and didn't eat when I was hungry, I didn't even know a lot because I was inside so much. But now I am better. TMI, but I had a lot of sex with people I barely knew. It was slowly making me miserable. I made the choice to stop cold turkey and reconnect with people that I cared about. That made a world of a difference. When I was full-throatedly and logically arguing that swapping dirty emails with a woman I'd never met was not cheating, while my then fiancé was crying. I found myself doing coke on a random Tuesday night. A friend had been dumped by the guy she was seeing, so we all got together to cheer her up. Some beers were had, everything seemed chill. Then suddenly everyone was railing lines of coke and getting really, really wasted. I remember looking around the room and thinking, what the actual frick am I doing here? That horrible moment of sobering lucidity that only appears when you and everyone else are fricked off your asses. God, I hate that feeling, but it's one to listen to. I don't hang out with those people anymore and I hope you don't either. Well, it started off with my girlfriend dumping me the day before my birthday. This occurred once we returned from a concert that I paid for in full. We got back, argued for a while, then broke up. Then I made the mistake of trying to make it work, all while wasting my birthday on her and ditching my mother, who wanted to spend some time with me and even took off work to spend the day together. Naturally, we broke it off again about a week or two later. Days after, my uncle with whom I was very close passed away from a second stroke. He had previously had one years before that messed him up pretty bad, but he had a very small chance of surviving the second. With no one to turn to, I talked with her about it. She seemed to at least pretend to care before eventually telling me, "I don't like you as a person." That moment was about the time when it all started clicking. I realized I was wasting my time on a bee that wasn't worth it. I stopped talking with her altogether soon after that, and despite her recent attempts to try to converse, I can safely say I am much happier now, and I do not plan to ever speak with her again. I was depressed. I hated where I lived. I couldn't leave the house because of constant nausea, which was putting a strain on my wife, and I almost killed myself. There is a creek not far from where I was living, and I was a second away from running down there and drowning myself. I'm glad I didn't. Turns out the nausea was all due to anxiety, so I started working on fixing my anxiety. Still a work in progress. I moved out of city with some good friends and my wife, and now we are pregnant and I couldn't be happier. So, for anyone with anxiety or depression, it will get better. The world isn't ending at all times. If you want any help on how I started to curb my anxiety, PM me. I would love to help. Anxiety sucks, but anxiety and feeling alone is much worse. I ran out of pain. When things got bad, I kept up because of a sense of hope. Things would get better, right? But I ran out of hope. Then duty took hope's place. I kept getting things done, because they had to be done. When duty went thin, I still had fear. Fear wants you when nothing else does. Fear looks a lot like duty from the outside, but it uses you up differently. When there isn't enough fear to get through the day, all you have is pain. Pain is not your enemy. Pain reminds you that you are still alive to feel it. Pain tries to keep you alive. You may hate it, but it loves you. When there isn't enough pain to keep you going, there is nowhere left to go. Whoa, this is beautifully written. I'm living in the second part of that, I think. I've lost all hope in everything really, but I've got to keep going because that's what you do. There are too many people attached to me at this point. I tell myself every day, keep existing, keep existing, keep existing. Ever since I moved to this new apartment far away from home, I've been searching for a new job but without any luck. I've been trying to get some new friends here, but it's really hard when I don't have school and work to socialize in. I've always been introverted, so it can be hard to force yourself to go out to parties and whatnot, but I have been trying to get out and talk with people when my two roommates have friends over. But my mood and energy just got worse and worse over time, until one day about 2 weeks ago, my roommates couldn't bear seeing me get worse. So they called me out to the kitchen where they really got me thinking straight and offered all the help they could give. They kinda forced me to call my parents and tell them about how I was doing, so that they also could help me out. They all really helped me a lot and the world really do seem brighter now. I got a job now and I'm currently talking with a girl that I really like. TLDR, you don't have to do everything by yourself. It's okay to ask for help. Glad you're doing better. Sounds like you have some awesome roommates and could potentially do awesome where you're living. When I stopped taking my antidepressants and got so depressed that I stopped going into work, I felt bad about it, but I was also too ashamed to let them know what was going on. Ended up living like a hermit and going nearly broke until I finally forced myself to find another job. Oddly enough, getting a job pulled me out of my depression. Sitting in a prison cell thinking I am about to go away for a year for defending myself against someone in my family, was looking back at my life that second and realized I have so much more potential than working crazy hours doing construction, living paycheck to paycheck, not having an education and being lazy. Promised myself if I wasn't locked up a change. I was proved innocent. I now work in finance in NY. I was in the midst of a cycle of bad decisions regarding everything from relationships and sex to alcohol and other numbing agents. Just a good old-fashioned spiral of self-destruction. But I didn't really think anything of it until a good friend who was set to come visit me decided to cancel his trip, saying I cannot support you and what you are doing and I think it's best if I just stay away from you for a while. It was a really shocking wake-up call for me. I immediately went and had a life-changing talk with my university chaplain and started working my way out of the hole one step at a time. I'm still cool with the guy who cancelled his trip out to see me. I wonder if he even realizes what an effect that had on me. Maybe I should tell him. You should. But make it clear that he's not responsible if you fail. If that makes any sense. When I would stay up all night on the weekends drinking rum and gaming, pee into empty rum bottles, playing Eve one night, poured myself a shot from the wrong bottle. At least it wasn't the bong water. Just a little under a month after my 25th birthday, this was last year August, I was looking at myself in the mirror disgusted with the way I looked, 5 feet 11 and 215 pounds. In that moment I decided to evaluate my life and this is where I was at, overweight, $19,000 in debt, in a toxic relationship and working a part-time job. That was then, now I am down to 155 pounds. $12,000 in debt, very happy single, dumped my GF at the start of November and still working at my part-time job but have more hours. I don't consider my part-time job a very bad thing cause it is a very good job. I would just like to move up to a full-time job so that I can get benefits. Got ghosted by a girl I roll, went into mild depression, then realize I have failed in my social life and I need to go on a diet. 6 months later, now I am 10 pounds less and begin exercise. This just happened to myself, the being ghosted part that is. I don't really know how I feel about it actually. Let's see. Post-military failing college, my plans usually consist of getting blackout drunk and driving home most nights. I had one friend who just got arrested for child P charges. My GF was emotionally abusive pretty badly. I had gotten homework, bouncer, had a case of beer and I walked to the park at 3 in the morning to drink the beer in the park. As I sat there on a park bench I just sat there contemplating what my life became. So I quit my job, dropped out of school and packed up my stuff and my car and moved halfway across the nation to live with my sister till I sorted my life out. She forced me to drink less, and slowly I got my life back together. I'm now living on my own. Got a job and a respectable wage. I'm working on getting my happiness back, working with my therapist to help me figure out what I want my direction in life to be, getting better self-confidence and trying to trust people again. Maybe one day I can start dating again, I don't know. The time I made a five-figure income, in a month, from selling insurance. It sounds stupid, arrogant, maybe both, but that's when it hit me that this wasn't what I wanted to do. Looked at my bank account to see if I had money for a $100 thing I was going to buy and seeing I had minus $500 in my savings. I couldn't sleep for a few days cause of it and stayed up all night applying for on-campus jobs and jobs close enough for me to walk, take the bus to, sold a bunch of my stuff, didn't buy anything for a few months. College campus meal plan covered me for food, worked one-off jobs, started buying things then flipping them for more money. Back on my feet now with another job lined up in a few months. These two moments happened in the same week and it had that cumulative effect. One was that I just barely fit on a roller coaster after not fitting on another one. The second was my wife showing me a video of me sleeping and sounding like I was gonna die any second due to sleep apnea. I'm down about 4 pounds as this was only 2 weeks ago but I'm hoping it sticks this time. I'd lost about 30 pounds last time, then my mom and dog died within a 2-month time frame and I gained it all back. Currently ongoing. A year out of college, still working internships. Friends are getting engaged, having babies, making parents proud, etc. I'm almost 3 years out of college, and I'm 100% not ready to have kids. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. Still working internships sucks. But honestly, you might be able to snag full-time soon. It's too soon to know what you want relationship-wise. I learned that a week ago. After spending a whole night, plus next morning and early afternoon, consuming copious amounts of C, when the come down hits you, I just wasn't prepared. Oh, you sweet summer child. when I accidentally turned on Snapchat lying down and couldn't see my neck. I call this the infinite chin event. When asked why I decided to get into shape, I was already having second thoughts about what I was doing to myself, but man, that sure tipped me over. TBF. Even attractive people look bad at that angle. I met an amazing girl that blew my mind, falling in love with all my heart for the first time in my life, in my 30s. I didn't know such emotions were possible to experience. Then she left me because of my traumas and issues due to the crap I've seen. That woke me up and made me get a grip of myself. She profoundly, and hopefully permanently, changed me for the better. Ironically, it wasn't really her love that changed me, but losing her. I don't resent her dumping my butt. It was the right decision for her. Perhaps one day I will find someone who makes me feel something like that again, and this time I will be worth it. It was right after my high school graduation and realized I was going home by myself. I didn't get invited anywhere. I didn't even know who I'd want to invite me anywhere. My mom was the only family member who cared enough to show. My mom actually planned a grad party for me, but we cancelled it because no one was coming except my neighbors. I had a long distance boyfriend and no self-esteem, so obviously my big plan to fix my life was to move in with him 300 miles away. 2 years later, I'm single and still have no friends, but I like myself a lot more and I'm going to college in August. I'm confident getting out of this small town and my comfort zone will be enough to meet some interesting people. Not me, one of my very good friends. Both his parents died when he was 21 years old. His dad used to answer every single question he had about adulthood and life. When his father passed away, he knew he was on his own now, so he did everything possible to pull himself together. He now has a wife, and living a very good life. I had taken a nap so I could stay up all night and party with the huge supply of coke and weed I'd stashed, and woke up to find my entire family in my living room, gathered for my intervention, almost 7 years ago, clean and sober. Frick yeah, sometimes the truth hurts but can help you wake up. Congrats on being sober. Getting out of rehab. It was like I just graduated high school again. Except back then I had a job and $5k saved up. Now I'm 27. $15k in debt. It feels really weird, but I got an apartment and job. A routine. I think this is the way people live. I dunno. I blend into society now. I'm always wondering what the whole point of life is. Feels really weird. I'm totally sober and happy, though. Just confused. The secret is, it's whatever you want to make it. 1993, pre-internet, working on a used car seller video show that was looped on a local cable network. My office was behind a Sears parcel pickup location at a basically dead mall. I'd come on at 8 a.m. and leave at 7 p.m. weekdays. I'd get film rolls, develop them on the Konica machines, change chemicals, print them, scan into a Mac, make a video and output to SVHS. Day in, days out, nobody to talk to. Company folded when our broadcasting cable company sold to a competitor who already has a service similar to ours. When I left college, came home, and realized I didn't want anything to do with my major after all, mechanical engineering. Just change. I went from aerospace to computer. There's a lot more room to switch over than you think. A wino woke me up when I was asleep outside the courthouse, passed out from a 3-day drink and drugs bender, and offered me a swig of his cider. Had a serious chat with myself after that occasion. In the middle of it right now, self-destructing on a few different levels and feel overwhelmed. I'm not a kid. I've been in similar positions before and thought myself more prepared than I seem to be at present. Ridiculous notions seem logical and logical things seem ridiculous. Anxiety, confusion and anger consume me. I need to reconcile the difference between where I am and where I need to be. Best of luck to anyone finding themselves in a similar position. I used to be fat, just that simple, no excuses for it. One day I was eating and watching Futurama, and Fry was eating Bachelor Chow. I looked at my Hot Pockets and realized they were human-scale hamster pellets. I made the choice to stop right there and get my crap together. I dropped a ton of weight over the next year, made fitness a lifestyle habit, and I've been better off for it ever since. Human scale hamster pellets, upvoted for amusing terminology, and congrats on the lifestyle change. About 2 months ago, my little sister got engaged. In that moment, I realized everything she has and everything I don't. She's 3 years younger than I am. She has friends, a job, a social life, just a life in general. And here I sit in my parents' basement, 30 and still sleeping in the same room I grew up in. Heck, I still sleep in the first and only bed I've ever had. I am unemployed. No friends or social life to speak of. I've actually seen my friends in person I think 4 or 5 times in the last 4 years. Except for running errands with my parents, I never leave the house. Plus earlier in the year I hurt myself and my dad drove me to the ER that night. Once they're gone, that's it. I'll be completely on my own. And I still rely on them a lot more than I am comfortable admitting to. Now I have to figure out how to change that. At the moment I am looking at joining the army. It'll get me out of the house and on my own, and give me a completely new outlook on life, and a complete change in location. Maybe I'll love it, maybe I'll hate it, or maybe I'll say it was the best mistake I ever made. At the very least I can say I did something. That's actually a pretty good plan if you have no direction. Please go for it ASAP. I'm just going to say it how it is. I'm a freaking punk butt 16-year-old butthole who dislikes a lot of people. I'm always getting into trouble and crap. But I recently moved schools to leave that behind. Well, it came back. So I decided on my own that I'm sending myself to a military school this summer. Two moments. I was working as a cleaner before college. A woman dripped period and crap nuggets all over the floor and watched me clean it. Then I went outside to pick up cigarette butts and this rich snobby lawyer started a fire in my waste bin. This happened for 15 days straight every day at 4:15 p.m. I looked at him and said, "Frick, I need to figure my crap out," and I quit on the spot. I was working as an AF technician. I had to work nights to support night school classes. I was walking with a huge ladder and a heavy as frick tool bag. I looked up at a projector and said, "This cannot be it," and then I went on a crazy job hunt. It was around the 4-year anniversary of working for an abusive employer. I needed the job to support my family, and he knew I had no other options but to take his abuse. The humility of the job was becoming intolerable and every night I would think, "I need to figure out my options and get the F out of here. My life is jacked up." The final straw was the day he asked for a file and as I was bent down he hit me on the back of my head. I grabbed my stuff and was out the door. When I was arrested for vagrancy and being an out-of-state homeless person, the actual moment was when these two 17, maybe 18-year-old kids walked into processing and the processing area erupted in cheers. Come to find out, they killed and raped a 16-year-old girl who was used as a honey trap for a popular gang member's brother. The girl lured the young brother to some abandoned house. He was beaten, tortured, and killed. Wow, I hate everyone involved within that story. Trying to join a business honor society at my university, but lost the membership information somewhere in my messy room and I don't know where when the ceremony is taking place. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.